premise true. In this video, we're going to continue our discussion of factoring polynomials and deal with specifically the difference of squares. There's some patterns that you want to memorize when you're learning factoring because, well, they show up so often and, you know, they follow this sort of special pattern that you don't need to, you know, actually really trudge your way, work your way through the problem and, you know, take up extra time. If you know the completing the square, the difference of squares pattern, excuse me, you can just look at a lot of problems and just see the answer like that. So we have a squared minus b squared. Now, that is equal to, when you factor it, a plus b times a minus b. Now, you might notice that our exponents of 2 are simply becoming exponents of 1. That's because, or how that is happening, is you're, you know, square rooting the first term to get a, and you're square rooting the second term to get b. So if I just take this, you know, if I just take the square root of a squared, you know, square rooting a number will undo, it's the inverse math operation of squaring a number. So that's just going to be equal to a. That's where that's coming from. So a is going to be the square root of the first term, and b is going to be the square root of the second term. Now also, before I start these examples, if you want to verify that your polynomial in factored form is actually indeed correct, well, all you have to do is distribute it together, or FOIL it together. I don't use, you know, this idea of FOIL, but your teacher probably does. So, you know, is a plus b times a minus b the same as a squared minus b squared? Well, a times a is a squared. When you multiply like bases, you add those exponents. A times negative b is negative ab. Positive b times positive a is positive ab. And b times negative b is negative b squared. Now, when you're dealing with, you know, this special pattern where it's a difference of squares, where your two binomials that I'm multiplying back together to actually check to make sure it works, when your two binomials have exactly the same first and second term, but the signs are different, well, what happens through the distribution process or the foiling process is what would have normally created your middle term, because normally when you multiply two binomials, you get a trinomial or three terms, they'll cancel out, giving you that difference. Difference. This minus sign is that negative sign. Difference of squares, because your middle term cancels out. Okay, so enough of the intro. I got four examples and I have a fifth one coming up, sort of like a bonus extra credit question, a little bit harder than you might find in your textbook, I'm not sure. But we have a difference of perfect squares. Now I know this is a perfect square because an exponent of 2, and I know 9 is a perfect square because, of course, perfect square to 9 is 3, or negative 3. If this were a 7, you can write square root of 7, but it's not identified as a perfect square because you can't square root that number and get a whole number answer. So I'm looking for perfect squares like 4, which is 2 times 2, 9, which is 3 times 3, 16, which is 4 times 4, and so on. Now, if I look at this, I can sort of, you know, envision square rooting that first and last term and identify that a is equal to x and b is equal to 3, and then fill in my pattern. So x squared minus 9 is equal to x plus 3, or a plus b, times x minus 3, or a minus b. That's a pretty simple one. Here, this next one, let's call it a leading coefficient that's not equal to 1, and two of our terms, both of our terms, have a variable with an even exponent. You can do completing the square process too if your exponents are odd, but that's not, you don't normally see that in, like, say, an Algebra 1 or maybe even an Algebra 2 book, so I'm going to ignore those and just deal with exponents which are even. So, well, now I'm out of the camera screen, let's just stand over here. So 4x squared minus 16y squared, a difference of squares. Well, the square root of that first term is 2x, so a is going to be equal to 2x, and the square root of the second term, I'm doing that lightly because I'm kind of like, you know, that's what you should be thinking in your head, The square root of the second term, notice I did not put the negative sign in it, by the way, you can't square root a negative number. The square root of 16 is 4, so b is equal to 4, and the square root of y squared is y. So a is 2x and b is 4y for this example. So 4x squared minus 16y squared is equal to 2x plus 4y, a plus b, times 2x minus 4y, a minus b. And again, you know, this is a pattern we're supposed to be following it. Hopefully now you're understanding how it works, but you could distribute this together to make sure it adds up to the, or comes out to the original problem. Not a bad idea, because you know how often you get problems on a test you can check before you even hand in the test. So distribute that back together, make sure it works. Here we have x to the fourth minus y to the fourth. Now, this is also a perfect difference of squares, but you see the exponents, they're not 2, they're 4. Again, a little bit more of an advanced problem. Well, just a second ago I wrote the square root of x squared, or maybe I wrote a squared or something like that. The square root of x squared, though, is equal to x to the first. The square rooting process, you know, will take your exponent and divide it by 2. I don't want to get too complicated if you haven't studied rational exponents, but the square root, the index of that radical, whatever that is, that's how you're going to change the exponents. We're taking the square root, so we're going to take all those exponents and divide them by 2. I want to talk about cube roots and fourth roots and so on, but we're doing a difference of squares, so I just want to focus on that square root. It is going to take the exponents and divide them by 2. That's how you go from 2 to 1. So if that were x to the fourth, the square root of x to the fourth is x squared. The square root of x to the fifth, we're not going to see this in this video, but that would be x to the 5 over 2. Just going to throw that in there in case you have dealt with rational exponents, where the top number is the power and the bottom number is the index of the root. Okay, so what does that mean? Difference, two terms, minus sign in the middle, so this is a difference of squares. Well, that means that I can square root the first term, square root the second term, and identify A as being x squared and B as being y squared, and walk through the difference of squares pattern. So this becomes x A plus B, so x squared plus y squared, that's the A plus B part, times x squared minus y squared. Again, the a plus b, a minus b. Okay, well, we're getting into factoring more, and you're not always done after one step of factoring. With this problem, I once again have another difference of squares set up. Now, this is a good point to stop and also say, we can factor a difference of squares, but we cannot factor a sum of squares. There's no such thing as, well, I mean, there is such a thing, it's right there, it's the sum of squares, but you cannot factor it. So, after factoring the original problem of x squared minus x to the fourth minus y to the fourth, we have something in factored form, but there is, once again, something else in there that can be factored further. So, this is, once again, a difference of squares, so our final answer is going to be x, let me just box this in because this is not, it's just scratch work. We have x squared plus y squared. And now here, we're going to factor that difference of squares again, and we're going to have x plus y times x minus y. Our last example just looks like a binomial. The first step of factoring should not be to look for a special case, or you're factoring this quadratic trinomial, that's a second degree trinomial or polynomial, trinomial. The first step of factoring is there anything in common that you can pull out of all the terms? Well, both of these terms both have a factor of 2, they both have an x and they both have a y, so I can factor a monomial out of these two terms. So we're going to take a 2x. They both have, the 2 and the 32 share a factor of 2. Both of these terms have an x, and we're going to take out that, let me get a brighter color here. We're going to take out that lowest exponent of 1. Both of these terms have a y, and we're going to take out that lowest exponent again of 1. And factor that out. Now, I just finished a whole video of factoring out monomials, and I showed the division step where you pull that GCF out. Now I'm just going to do it in my head. 2 divided by 2 is equal to 1, which I'm not going to write, but it's 1. X to the third divided by x to the first, if I have 3 x's and I'm taking one of them out, that leaves me with 2 of them left, or x squared, minus, because we're dividing by a positive number, so minus 32 divided by 2 is 16. I've got 1 x and I'm taking that only x out that this term has, and this second term has 3 y's and I'm taking one of them out, that's going to leave me with 2. Oh, okay. So I had just a binomial, but after factoring out the 2 xy, I get a difference of squares again. So this is a multi-step problem when we're factoring here with this one. Let me get my blue chalk. Square root the first term. Just a second. Sorry for interruption. So we're going to square root the first term, square root the last term, and identify A as being equal to x, and B as being the square root of 16y squared. Well, the square root of 16 is 4. And the square root of y squared is y. So, I've taken out my 2xy, I've factored out a monomial, but I've got that binomial left, that difference of squares. So my final answer is going to be 2xy times, okay, let's see here, a is x and b is 4y. It's going to be a plus b, or x plus 4y times x minus 4. I got one more example for you, that sort of extra credit, kind of extra hard example. Last example. Now, this one is a bit more complicated looking, but these parentheses are locking this term all together. So this is something squared minus something squared. So while it looks a lot more complicated, it's exactly the same as even the first example. We're going to identify this first term here, A, as being, well, what's inside? What is being squared? X minus y. So a is going to be x minus y, and b, well, b is in the second term, and it's x plus y. So if you like, I can temporarily just, you know, say, well, that's a, and this is b, and it's a squared minus b squared. So a squared minus b squared is a plus b times a minus b. See, I'm writing the pattern out for you, and we're just going to look at the formula because this is kind of a complicated question, and just sort of go, okay, well, here's a, here's b. This is something squared minus something squared. So that's a plus b times a minus b. Okay, well, these bases are a lot more complicated, but the parentheses are locking it all together. A is x minus y, and a goes in the, you know, first two blanks, and b is x plus y. Now, because this one is a bit more complicated than all the other problems, we're going to go ahead and simplify, you know, what's left. Well, here we have x. These parentheses I've put in as placeholders, but there's no coefficient, there's no exponent, there's no division, so it's not really doing much. They're really not doing anything except for highlighting where a was and where b was. So x plus x is 2x, and y, negative y plus a positive y, well, when I try and put those two like terms together, negative y and positive y cancel out. Negative 1 plus 1 is 0. So that's just going to be 2x times, over here, now I'm going to remind you that we do have a negative in between those, and maybe even just show a little scratch work. We have x minus y, negative 1 times x is negative x, and negative 1 times y is negative y. Okay, well, what do we have? We have x minus x, which is equal to 0, and we have negative y and negative y. Well, minus 1 or negative 1 minus another negative 1, or not, you can't minus, not minus in the negative 1, but subtracting 1, is negative 2. So negative 2y. And I couldn't add these things, but you know, I couldn't add these terms, but they're not terms because there's not an addition or subtraction sign in the middle, but I can multiply, and 2 times negative 2 is negative 4xy. And that is your sort of extra credit bonus. I'm Mr. True. Go do your homework.